from the word katha, which means a story. Kathakars or storytellers narrate stories largely based on episodes from the epics, myths and legends. It probably started as an oral rendition. Mime and gestures were perhaps added later on to make the recitation more effective. Thus evolved a simple form of expressional dance, providing the origins of what later developed into Kathak as we see today. The technique is built by the use of an intricate system of footwork. Pure dance, nritya, is all important, where complex rhythmic patterns are created through the use of the flat feet and the control of the sound of the ankle bells worn by the dancer. Kathak builds its pure dance sequences by combining units of movement, and the cadences are differently named. Tukda and Tora, a composition of syllables performed within a definite time cycle. Paran, composition of syllables of the ancient percussion called Pakhavaj. Tihais are compositions of rhythmic patterns performed only through footwork. The various combinations of rhythmic passages, all punctuated with and culminating in a number of pirouettes. The pirouettes are the most characteristic feature of the dance style in nritya portion. Recitation of the rhythmic syllables is common, and the dance often pauses to recite these to a specified metrical cycle followed by execution through movement. The nritya portion of Kathak is performed to the nagma. Both the drummer pair and the dancer weave endless combinations in a repetitive melodic line. The metrical cycle tala of 16 beats provides the foundations, and the whole edifice of dance is built. We now present to you TEENTAL by Anya and Liana. Anya and Liana are here with us from Moscow on a scholarship, and they have received their initial training with Guruji Sri Raghav Bhatt at Moscow, and presently they are learning, they are continuing their practice with Srimati Mangala Ji. Now we present to you TEENTAL, which is choreographed by Raghav Bhatt and Mangala Bhatt.